I'm Adam, and this is my professional. So to start with, the context that I decided to go with is water harvesting. Going into water harvesting, I don't know the area that well, so I just thought stick quite local. So I just thought I'd look into the city and the people that majority of the people that actually use the city, the CBD, so business and students and residential people within the city. And scenarios, it's a bit of a broad scenario that isn't specific, but just the basis on the contrast of having widespread droughts and flooding basically leads to not much accessible of safe drinkable water. So I just wanted to create something that was able to generate annual safe water stream. So first of all, I thought if I'm in the CBD, I wanted to get an idea of what I'm kind of dealing with, if that makes sense. So I looked at buildings in Australia, the top four, two of them were in Brisbane and Wales. This got me thinking, I looked into the buildings. For example, I looked at the top 50 buildings in Brisbane, and they range from 24 stories to 74 stories high. And you think how small the CBD is and all those tall buildings, most of them are residential. That just basically means a shed load of people in a pretty small area. Everyone's going to be washing hands, brushing their teeth, flushing the toilet, drinking water. So that's a lot of water being used in a very small area. So I wanted to try and focus on that and generate water within the area as well. This was quite interesting actually. I just did some research and I thought, if I'm looking at how limited water supplies are within Australia, I thought, how much do Australia actually use? I'm quite interested. It is dated 2002, and I know the government's brought in new rules and stuff to overcome this. But the fact that Australia is actually the third worst country for the amount of water withdrawal. And just for a bit of fun, I thought, we're better than you. So I thought, if I'm focusing on the CBD, I went around and took pictures of places and obviously used Google Images to get some inspiration of different objects and products within the CBD, and what I could either manipulate to generate to harvest water or redesign as a way of harvesting water. So looking at ATD first of all, the first one I used was spider's webbing and how it generates water by condensed air or humidity in the air. And by doing so, it takes the droplets on the webbing, wraps it around the air, so it just by gravity goes to the bottom, so it's easy access for the spider. And then obviously, if you don't know, this makes fog nets and stuff. So from that, I just thought, streetlights, if you've got a very full of streetlights, if you could just incorporate that fog netting within the streetlight, each one isn't going to generate that much water, but how much little cost it would be to put the fog net on the streetlight. I thought it would make a big difference over time. And then just redesigning it so you could have some trench ways and stuff and it all falls down and then you can gather the bottom so it's accessible water and stuff. The second one was the Namib desert beetle. Again, mentioned it earlier how it harvests water on its back and feeds through its mouth. And from this I thought about road signs. I thought if you've got pretty big road signs around the place and pedestrian signs as well. And I just thought if you could have the dimples within on the road sign, you could actually harness all the water just from that. So I've got here, the water's coming down and then funneling down into the legs that actually hold the sign up, and then you can store it in there, just like a tap at the bottom where it can go to an underground storage system. And again, one might not generate that much water, but if you do that to multiple, it will create one. And the third one was the Thorny Devil Lizard, I think it's called. And it's quite clever. It funnels water around its body using spikes, and then using capillary action, it can actually draw up water from the ground, which I thought was quite interesting. And at first I thought that could be used on buildings to transfer water up to the top of buildings, but that's just a little bit of an idea. But instead I decided to use it on public benches. So with this, I've noticed you don't get in England, so you don't really drink that much because it's not hot, but there's loads of water features everywhere. So I thought if you could incorporate the water feature on the bench, it means you don't have to get up if you want to drink. you sat there and using capillary action, it could draw up water from the water that's already been harnessed by the bench. So the idea is the bench is shaped like it is, so any rainwater, and then you've got fog nets in the hollowed out shape that harnesses the water. And this is like a cross section with the arm there, and then through the bench, you can see all the pipe like working with inside the bench. So all the water is then generated, and then if someone wants to drink, it's actually the water that's used to drink. So if there's an overflow, what happens? It's probably not going to happen, but if it did, obviously you're not going to have a massive storage tank under every single public bench or light or street sign. So I thought about having a natural system within Brisbane, and like if it was to happen, obviously you'd have to dig up the roads, which is but if it was, I thought it'd be quite cool if you could actually link all these different objects up and make a complete harvesting system within the CBD. And from that, you could use the variety of different uses for it, so like providing water to public toilets. I see a lot of these things, like Brisbane is a pretty clean city. Every night there are cleaning the streets, so I thought the government could use that to then take water from the storage tank outside the CBD, where you get pumped or whatever. In summer it can be used to water the plants in the botanical gardens and things like that. So that's my final design. I kind of came up with three different designs, really, so I just wanted to focus on different objects within the CBD. So it's kind of a bizarre outcome, I think, but not actually got a specific final product, but that's my final one. And that's to show in context there. And
similar issues. What does it collect? What do you get from? Yeah, great, thanks.